Hello and welcome back to this Machine Learning and AI Beginner Series. In this video, we're going to be talking about how you can use ChatGPT to extract insights from your data. In this video, we're going to expand on context sources beyond chat history and examples. We're also going to do an introduction to the Retrieval Augmented Generation pattern, or RAG pattern, and we're going to show in a few samples how you can use ChatGPT to answer questions about your data. So, when it comes to context sources, there's a few that we've already reviewed. For example, we have the chat or the message history. And again, right, that's the log of the conversation that has took place at a certain point in time with ChatGPT. We also have sample responses. Now, when you provide these sort of sample responses or examples of what you want your output to look like, right, this is known as few-shot learning. And you see here, for example, that if you try to extract airport codes from a piece of text, you can see that the response returns the airport codes here. And there's an additional way that you can add context to a conversation with ChatGPT, and that is data and documents. Now, these can be PDFs, images, any sort of data that you have available to you, right? You're able to use that as context to provide relevant and generate relevant responses from these models. A common way of using ChatGPT to extract insights from your data is known as the Retrieval Augmented Generation pattern. Now, generally, the way that this works is a user submits a question or an instruction, right? You submit a prompt. And as opposed to in the previous examples where you were directly interfacing and sending that prompt to ChatGPT or your language model to generate responses, in this case, you're going to first perform a query on data sources to find the most relevant documents. You're going to then take the results of that query and get those most relevant documents, and you're going to craft a prompt that contains both your original user question or your instruction, as well as the retrieved documents as context. This prompt that you just created, you're then going to submit that to ChatGPT to generate a response, and then this response is what gets returned to you, the user. Okay. As a reminder, any of the samples that you see in this video can be found at aka.ms/dotnet-ai-beginner. Let's take a look at some code. So in this sample, again, we start off by installing the Azure OpenAI.net SDK. And again, you can find that over at the azure.ai.openai NuGet package. We add our using statements, we get our OpenAI service credentials from these environment variables, and we go ahead and configure our OpenAI client. Then we define our system prompt. Now, if we take a look at this prompt, you're gonna see that we are giving some instructions to this particular agent. We're saying, you're an AI assistant that helps users answer questions about their data, right? So you're already framing and constraining only to your data. You have access to articles to help you answer questions, and you want to use only the contents from these documents to answer questions, okay? So again, the system prompt is what's gonna be guiding your agent in terms of what it's intended to do. Now, in this case, we're gonna also define some data objects, right? This is sort of the format that our data sort of looks like. A document consists of embeddings and metadata. This metadata containing things like title, the text of an article, an ID, and then a paragraph ID here. Right. Now, embeddings are beyond the context of this conversation. However, I encourage you to check out the Azure OpenAI service documentation to get more details here. Now, we've also have some utility functions for formatting the messages, and then we also have an utility function for rendering the user prompt. And you're going to see that this prompt will take in the chat history. It's also going to take in some documents, as well as the original user query. And using a prompt template here, we're just going to replace the values from the template with, again, our actual chat history, the relevant documents that we retrieved, and our user query. Now, in order to find relevant documents, we need to have a way of retrieving them. And so the way that we do that is by comparing how similar the embeddings of a particular document are to a user query. Right? And that's how we're able to find the most similar documents. In this case, we are loading the data. Now, our data is inside of a JSON file, but you could imagine this being some sort of data store, a vector store, or some sort of database of some sort. In this case, we've kept it simple, and it's just a JSON file. And you're going to see that, again, there's this embedding, which is just a numerical representation of the text of these individual Wikipedia articles. And then, again, this is just what that first entry looks like. Then we go ahead and configure our chat completion options. We initialize our chat history, and then we can sort of start chatting. Now, before I start the chat, I just want to point out how this maps to the retrieval augmented generation pattern that we talked about earlier. So we start off here by getting that user input. And again, before sending this directly to our OpenAI or ChatGPT model, we first perform a query for the most relevant documents. Okay. Once we have the most relevant documents, we go ahead and we generate that user prompt. And the way that we do that is by passing in the message history, passing in the relevant documentations that were retrieved, and again, our original user input. And then last but not least, this prompt is then submitted to ChatGPT in order to generate an answer for us. So let's take a look at what this looks like in action. Okay, let me start with this chat, and then let's ask it, how many goals did Cristiano Ronaldo score in 2014? Okay, and if we start taking a look at that, we can see that we have the chat history as part of our prompt. We also have the sources, right? So it performed a lookup for the most relevant sources, and we actually have some documents inside of our database about Cristiano Ronaldo. And then you can see that there's our query here. And the response from the assistant is that Cristiano Ronaldo scored 17 goals in the 2013-2014 Champions League season. Great. Okay, now let's see, was this a personal record for him? All right, and again, it pulls relevant sources. And we can see that based on our sources, that's 2014-2015. That's when he set a personal record of 61 goals in the competitions. And then here, you can see that in the response, it says his personal record was set in 2014-2015 by scoring 61 goals. Okay, great. Who held the record before him? Okay, you can see that Lionel Messi was the one who had the record before him. And I believe if we look through some of the sources here, you're going to find that the information is there. Now let's ask it a different question about something that it doesn't know about. So when was the U.S. Declaration of Independence signed? Okay, so now there's no documents inside of my database about the U.S. Declaration of Independence, and you can see that given the sources do not provide on the date of the U.S. Declaration was signed, right? So again, it's not able to answer that question because it doesn't have access, or at least in my database, it doesn't have any information about the U.S. Declaration of Independence. All right. So in this video, you learned that you can use data and documents as an additional source of context when you're having conversations or chats with ChatGPT. And the way that you do that is with this pattern known as the Retrieval Augmented Generation pattern. In a few samples, we also showed how you can use ChatGPT to answer questions about your data and how you can get started unlocking the insights from your enterprise data. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.